In this video, we're going to see my top picks on software programs which come in handy to architects and architecture students. What's going on, fellas? I'm Geo and this is Geo Creations. Let's jump right into the video. Learning software is one of the most important parts in architecture. Nowadays, these programs are really improved and can bring your ideas to real life pretty easily. There are a wide variety of software, each serving a different purpose. And I'll share my personal workflow by the end of this video. Before getting into the detailed list, consider joining the small community by subscribing to the channel for new architecture content every Wednesdays. Okay, first, let's start with BIM. BIM stands for Building Information Modeling, which is a perfect all-rounder for doing stuff from plans, sections, elevations, as well as 3D models. These are some of the BIM programs out there. ARCHICAD is one of the most user-friendly BIM software. Autodesk Revit is the most popular one. If you are looking for a job, this will have the most weightage. Vectorworks also delivers a solid utility when it comes to BIM. Now let's look on to 3D modeling software. Starting with SketchUp, which is my favorite software even as a BIM. Yes, you heard me. I'm in my final year of architecture and I haven't used BIM in any of my projects because SketchUp is a lot more intuitive and with a wide range of plugins, you can just do anything. I have made a separate video on my top picks on SketchUp extension. Check that out by clicking on this I button or check the link in the description. Let's move on to the next one, Rhino. Rhino is so far the most efficient 3D modeling software out there, which can handle both NURBS as well as meshes. Working with NURBS cuts down a lot of performance load on your PC, which will be a very useful option if you have a slower PC. You can mold out any shape or form out of this pretty easily. And it has one of the coolest plugins out there, which is Grasshopper, which I'll cover further in this video. The only drawback of this software is its learning curve, but it's definitely worth learning it. And you can also use other mesh-based software like 3ds Max, Maya, Blender, or Cinema 4D, which can also do rendering and animation. Now let's move on to the next section, 2D drafting. In this category, AutoCAD is hands down the best because of its nature of doing precise 2D detailed drawing, which we can't easily achieve with BIM software. And there's also a 3D part which no one really cares. Now the most interesting part, parametric modeling. Parametric architecture is gaining more and more popularity day by day. Having an algorithm-driven tool will always help you to bring something completely out of the box and also help you to practically implement them. Here I have did an animation with camera movement all purely based on precise algorithmic data. This is Grasshopper, a Rhino plugin which definitely takes a whole video to explain it properly. So let's just stick with the basics. Like Grasshopper for Rhino, we have Dynamo for Revit, but I don't really think it has the same flexibility as Grasshopper. Software like V-Ray and Corona are plugins which can be used with most of the 3D software that can give you an outstanding visual appeal. And we have another one category of renderers, which is real-time rendering engines. These are mostly standalone programs except for some few like Enscape. Some of the popular real-time renderers are Lumion, Twinmotion, Enscape, etc. These are easier and time-saving renderers as compared to the conventional ones. Let's check out some of the post-processing software up there. And here comes the kingpin, Photoshop, which is the most essential and powerful software which can boost up your presentation to a whole new level. Photoshop purely works on pixels. Unlike Photoshop, which is raster-based, Adobe Illustrator is vector-based, like AutoCAD, which is non-destructive and also comes with a ton of tools for graphic designing. And for multiple page documents, InDesign has the best tools at their disposal. And these three programs go hand in hand, which means files in one software can be linked to another and updates automatically while doing changes. Premiere Pro and After Effects will be a bonus if you are providing a video-based output like walkthrough or some intuitive graphical representations like this. Premiere Pro is a video editing software. After Effects is used for VFX and motion graphics. And here are some other programs which will be useful at times. Microsoft Excel is a very useful program when it comes to data analysis, estimation, etc. PowerPoint will help you with tiny presentations Likewise, Microsoft Word can also be really useful when you don't want to learn InDesign. So here are my topics on each category of software, and my software workflow usually includes Rhino plus Grasshopper for basic modeling and analysis, SketchUp for detailed modeling and assigning materials, preferably Lumion for rendering, and most importantly, Photoshop for post-processing. By the way, let me know your software workflow in the comments. If you got some value so far, don't forget to hit that like button. And this is my first video with a face cam on YouTube. And also, this is the first video after hitting 1000 subscribers. Thank you all for supporting this channel. And if you haven't already, consider joining this community by subscribing to the channel. Share this video with someone who will find this useful. Catch you guys in the next video. See ya.